Hey everybody, welcome to the Master's Room Whiskey Room. It's actually not the Whiskey Room. I'm here in New York at my mom's house. It looks like my intro wouldn't work for a second there. How's everybody doing tonight? It's Whiskey Wednesday. It's a little bit different of a scene here, obviously. Thank you so much for coming in. I was really glad I'm able to do this live stream tonight with you guys. Hope you all can hear me pretty well. So kind of a makeshift setup here at my mom's house. Hoping everything works okay. She got some new internet, so it actually the speed and everything should be up to par here. So really excited. Let me start with saying hi to everybody here tonight. Here we go. We have Trev Wilson. He's always the first one here. Thanks so much, Trev, for coming in. Brandon Elliott's in the house. Carl H. Rebecca Page dropped in. She's out on her lunch break. Thanks for dropping in, Rebecca. Appreciate it. Steve A is here as always. Thanks so much, man. Robot Scott's here. OG Brick. Steven Sussman. The Bourbon Road. How you doing, Jim? Thanks for coming in. Chad Wallace. Karen B4. Dark Meat Chicken. Live from New York. It's Whiskey Wednesday. Exactly. Bourbon Buddies is here. Andrew Spurrell. Happy Whiskey Wednesday. Eric Waits in the house. Captain Make It Happen all the way from Texas. ADHD Fishing. My favorite commenter in the chat. How you doing, man? Peter White's here. Scott from My Bourbon Journey. How are you, man? Hey, Sean Moore, Swan, the Bourbon Finders in the house. Thanks for coming in, Swan. Rob Davies here. Stellar Matrix. Thanks for coming in, Stellar. Appreciate it. Dram Bam, thank you, ma'am. How you doing? Christopher David's here. Jesse Page. Dram Man Kentucky. Haven't seen you in a bit. How you doing, man? Thanks for coming in. Tim Gargis. Eli's here. Juan Quintanilla, Whiskey Mick, bunch of people coming in. Ma, the meatloaf, exactly. All right, you guys can hear me. All right, awesome. Shout out to Mom for the internet upgrade. Hell yeah. All right, audio sounds good. We are good to go. Joseph Brazo. And as usual, he asks, what the hell are you doing in here? Well, we are here for Whiskey Wednesday night. So I got here yesterday. And I did some whiskey hunting today in hopes I would find some cool bottles to share with you guys tonight and talk about. And the one cool bottle I did find was a whiskey that we talked about last week on the live stream, which is the brand new Mic Drop. So this is the Mic Drop Batch 3 release. And we'll go through all the details for this bottle before we get into it. What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to pour a little bit of this now because we're going to get into it a little bit later. Oh. Hey, what's up? Pal Joey's in the house. How you doing, man? I'm going to pour this out a little bit. And for the first dram of the night, let me know what you guys are sipping tonight. The first dram of the night, I went into my mom's liquor cabinet. And she actually has acquired a really cool collection right now. She's got six bottles of Henry McKenna just hanging out in the cabinet, which she's a big Henry McKenna fan. She also has my 1792 pick here from Liquor Barn, which I had sent her, which she really likes. But tonight we're gonna start with a good old Wild Turkey 101. Yep, she's got the big old handle, so we're gonna start with that tonight, guys. Let's see, checking in. What are we drinking? We're starting off with some Wild Turkey 101 right here. Let me pour some of that. Get more of that. I'm on vacation, baby. Let's do this. All right, there we go. I'll show you guys some of the other bottles I found today. Got some really cool finds. Nothing mind-blowing, but just some kind of cool bottles that I was able to find. So we have, let's see, Angel's Envy Port Finish, Knob Creek Rye, Little Lejeune for Cap and Make It Happen. Hey, Dusty Dan is in the house. How you doing, Dusty? Steven Sussman's drinking McKenna. Awesome. Bourbon Road, he's sipping on Wilderness Trail Weeded. Oh, the five-year-old. Oh, I'm very jealous, Jim. Yeah, Mom knows what's up. She likes a 101, man. Michter's 10 in the glass. You think she has some Dusties in the cabinet. I did acquire somewhat of a Dusty. I really don't think it's a Dusty, but it's an older bottle. We're going to get into that first. But first, let's have the first pour of the night, guys. Cheers. Thanks for joining me on this Whiskey Wednesday night. Cheers, everybody. Damn, Wild Turkey 101's hard to beat, man. Oh, it's so good. It's like the perfect combination of cinnamon, spice, cherry, oak, vanilla, caramel. Just, it's really hard to beat for that price, always. Steve A's got some Maker's 46. Nice. Christopher David's drinking Barrel Dovetail. I love that stuff, man. Really good stuff. All right, so let's go through some of the bottles I found today because I had some pretty good luck here. So one of the ones I found, we already talked about the mic drop. One bottle that I've been wanting to find for a while and finally got it. It's not, I haven't seen it in Ohio yet. I got a sample this a while ago. It's actually an Irish whiskey. This is the Teeling Whiskey Single Grain, which I know a lot of people are a big fan of this one. And I'm going to be doing a review of the three core Teeling offerings. So the single grain, the single, and the small batch. So I'm going to do all three of those in one video. But this was the one that I was missing, so I cannot wait to get into that one. So yeah, Teeling single grain, which is awesome. Next one we got, this one I just found today. And this was in the back of the shelf. You know, you do some digging when you get to a good store. And I found a full bottle of one of these, baby. Dusty Turkey, Rare Breed, the 116.8 proof. I was so happy to find this. And I got it for the low, low price of $43.99. So, hell of a steal in my book. Rare Breed is one of the best barrel proof bargains on the shelf. So, was really happy to find that one. Let's see. All right, next one I got was the Stag Junior, and this is batch 12, which I haven't had yet. So I know 13 is out and starting to hit around a little bit, but batch 12 comes in at 127.9. So got me a bottle of batch 12. I had a sample of it, and I really, really loved it. So really happy to try that one. And my last bottle that was waiting for me when I got here, which is a travel exclusive, is actually a scotch. And it is the Talisker Dark Storm. Yeah. I'm so psyched for this one. So this is, so for those of you who are fans of Talisker or don't know much about Talisker, they're considered a maritime scotch, a maritime malt. You know, nice kind of salty, oceanic type flavor notes to it. But the one that makes this special is it's matured in charred casks. So it's a little bit darker. It's a little bit richer in flavor. Always heard great stuff about this. So I cannot wait to crack this one open too. So yeah, those are my finds so far. I'll probably do a few more hunting when I'm in Queens and Manhattan, see if I find anything else. But I did meet up with my favorite store here in New York, and she has some bottles coming in that should be able to get pretty soon in September. So I cannot wait to review those and share those with you guys. So, yeah. Let's see. Just picked up batch 13. Oh, so Trev, you got a batch 13. Nice. Stag Junior, the rare breed that is. Yeah, good bottles right there. Brandon Knight said, you bastard. Thank you. My area hasn't seen any Stag Junior since batch 10. Nick Foles. Yeah, I don't get Stag Junior in Ohio at all. I never see it. So whenever I come here, I grab any batch that I see. I got a batch 9 the last time I was here. I was hoping to get another one of those, but they just didn't have any. More Wild Turkey. Yeah, definitely good finds. All right. So, real quick, guys, I want to thank my patrons. A lot of you are in the chat tonight. If you are a patron of my channel, I want to give a quick shout out to you. I got a few new patrons this last week, including Bootlegger. Thank you for coming in. He is a legendary drummer at $25 a month. Thank you so much, man. I appreciate it. A lot of other users in the chat are also patrons, so I can't say thanks enough, and I really appreciate the support. If you want to become a patron, go to patreon.com/themashingdrum. Support the channel for as little as $1 a month. And, yeah, we have a lot of fun. I'm doing more stuff, some more live streams on Patreon to make it worth your while. So thanks so much. And with that, let's get into the whiskey news. You didn't think I was going to come here and not have any news for you, because there are some kind of cool things going on. First news story first, but before we do that, I want to drink some more, so I'll have some more Wild Turkey. Cheers. Hey, Tabby Keys in the house. How you doing? Tim Garda said, at least you could find some stag hard to get in Georgia. Yeah, man, the stag junior stuff is so, like, crazy. I hear places that just have pallets of it, and some places that they don't get it at all. Like Ohio, I think it came in once this whole year, and it was gone like that because it just never hits. Robot Scott, when is mom coming on? She is not coming on. She's hiding. She doesn't want to be on camera. She's one of those moms. Peter White said, the harder to find Talisker travel bottle is North 57, 114 proof. Oh, all right, Peter. I'll keep an eye out for that one. Okay, let's go into the first news story. I don't know if you guys heard about this. This was an interesting story that I did not know that happened. This is a picture of Castle and Key. If any of you guys have been there, they're just outside the visitor center. This was like an old, I think it was an old kind of like a bathhouse. That now the water that comes in through Castle and Key comes through here, and that's what they use for their spirits. But Castle and Key dumped untreated wastewater into Glen's Creek, which was just nearby. It's kind of more troubling news for the Kentucky bourbon distilleries. The water treatment facility failed last week, dumping an unknown amount of untreated and oxygen-depleted wastewater into Glen's Creek. The Kentucky Division of Water responded after reports of water discoloration and more dead fish started coming in. They were able to halt the discharge by 4 p.m., roughly 2 hours after the initial reports came in. Of course, this comes after the fire that just happened at Jim Beam. The distillery will be issued a notice of violation, though the specific penalty won't be announced until officials can meet with the brand and determine what caused the malfunction. So, just more kind of crazy stuff happening with distilleries. It seems like the more production and the busier these distilleries are getting to produce more stuff, it's, you know, inevitable that, you know, bad things could happen. Even though, you know, Jim Beam was struck by lightning, apparently. So, Steven Sussman says, oh yeah, Castle and Key destroying the creek there. Yeah, that's what it says. You know, it's never good when you're you're killing wildlife. It's always just kind of a sad thing to hear. I'm kind of a mush when it comes to like dogs and animals, and so just whenever I hear stuff like that, it's just kind of, even if it's fish, just kind of hits me in the gut a little bit. Yeah, more environmental influence. It's kind of crazy. So let's go to the next story, guys. This is about Amazon. Amazon appears to be operating a fake liquor store in Los Angeles. In February, Amazon began offering on-demand alcohol delivery in Los Angeles. The liquor license requires the holder to operate a public-facing brick-and-mortar store if it wishes to offer on-demand alcohol delivery services. Now, the license further stipulates that the store must be open for at least half the hours that the warehouse makes deliveries, and the store hours must be available at the entrance to the store. The California Department of Alcoholic Beverage Control has opened an investigation into the matter after Wine Searcher brought the issue to its attention. So last week, Distiller shared news of Amazon's plans to open a similarly tiny liquor store in San Francisco as well. So I kind of like that Amazon, this big, you know, conglomerate, big empire that we know of Amazon, tried to open this little liquor store. And then you have Wine Searcher, who is also an online retailer, kind of went after them and said, you know, they're not following this rule, this rule, this rule. And now they're getting investigated. So where the whole Amazon thing goes with delivering, I think there's a lot of things that need to be talked about before anything starts happening with, Amazon delivery. You know, I know that there are some liquor stores that do ship and deliver, but, you know, when Amazon gets in the game, that's a completely different animal to me. You know, then, you know, you start looking into, you know, you have the whole thing with people stealing packages off of people's porches or stoops or front doors. You know, what if kids are doing that? They start drinking alcohol underage. I mean, there's just a lot of factors that could come into that. You know, Amazon prime me a bottle of, you know, such and such. I don't know. I think it's a slippery slope. But if it does happen, it's got to be seriously regulated in my eyes. But we'll see what happens. All right, let's see. Yeah, that's the interwebs for you. Well, somebody said they got country ham. Let's see here. Who got that one? Eli got two Booker's country ham at $60 each today. Damn, Eli, that's awesome. I think I'm going to get another one. I love that country ham so much from Booker's, a new release. I think I might get another. All right, here's some bottle news, guys. Here we go. This is a kick-ass bottle. Highland Park releases the peatiest whiskey yet to date, the Volfather. It's kind of dark, Darth Vader-ish looking. Released globally in August 2019, the Volfather is the final whiskey in the limited edition Viking Legend trilogy, which was following the Valkyrie, which was 2017, and the Valknut, released in 2018. So whiskey maker Gordon Motion introduced a higher amount of locally produced peated malt for the trilogy. In fact, Volfather is said to be the peatiest whiskey to date from the distillery, matured in refill casks, and is bottled at 47% ABV. The Volfather is about $72 American. So that is the... I think we just got a super chat too, Jason. Arthur Lopez donated $4.99 through the super chat. He writes, cheers, Jason, and cheers to chat. Found a bottle of Booker's 30th at a hole in the wall. However, the store owner knows what he has and is charging $800. Oh, my God. That's crazy. That's crazy. Thank you so much, Arthur. I want to say cheers to you. Thanks for coming in, hanging out this Whiskey Wednesday night. Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Did everyone see the little dancing? What's his name? Did everyone see the little dancing graphic of Ron Swanson on the screen? I'm just wondering. Hey, Rarebird 101's in the house. How you doing? Thanks for coming in, David. Appreciate it. It's like a combination of like the Pittsburgh Steelers and Darth Vader like got together and made this bottle. It's kind of cool. I don't have a PPM count on this. It does not say. But it's supposed to be its peatiest whiskey yet. I'm curious to see how peaty this is going to be. So let's go to the next story, which is about Remus. NGP announces its third Remus Repeal Reserve Straight Bourbon. Remus Repeal Reserve 3 Straight Bourbon is the third release in the series to commemorate Prohibition Repeal Day. These are all NGP. You know, from two high rye mash bills. So the breakdown is 12% with a 21% rye, 78% with a 21% rye, and 10% with 36% rye. So this is limited release set to launch on November 13th, the birthday of the brand's namesake, George Remus, the king of bootleggers. Bottled at 100 proof and priced at $85. So this one I've always seen around. It's been a little bit pricey. I've never pulled the trigger on it. It's MGP, so it's probably pretty good. But if any of you have ever had this one in the chat, let me know. And final story of the day, Widow Jane has announced a 14-year-old called The Vaults. This is an inaugural release in a series of limited editions called The Vaults. This is a blend of straight bourbons aged 14 years and up. This is a blend of stuff from Indiana and Tennessee, so probably MGP and George Dickel. Widow Jane head distiller Lisa Wicker selected and blended 20 barrels, then finished the whiskey for 9 months in new charred oak casks made with wood seasoned that is left outside to dry and cure for 8 years. Price on this will be $150. Proof 49.5%. The release is next month in September. There's only going to be 3,000 bottles. So that is the news for tonight, guys. So I just wanted to share that with you. Rarebird says, stay while I can. No, I appreciate it, man. Thanks for coming in. Let's all just dance it out. Yeah. Yeah, cool bottle, Stellar. I definitely agree with you. I like the Art Deco label. It's a really cool bottle. It stands out, but I can't say I've had it. It's about $80, like I said. So, all right. One other piece of news I want to mention, for those of you that are big fans of the Old Forester 1910, I think I mentioned it on my stream last week. They're going to start hitting the stores again this week. Old Forester did announce that they're bottling some more of it, that they're it takes a while to create the 1910, considering the double barreling, the custom barrels they have to use, and that second barreling. So, if you guys are fans of it, keep a lookout because it's coming back on the shelves. Karen B. Ford asked, the Jim Beam Distillery did not have the new Booker's Country Ham last week. Three employees did not even know it existed. Finally found a manager, said they might get it this week. Okay. Rarebird 101 says, don't know about y'all, but I'm excited for Rare Breed Rye. David, is that a thing? Is that happening? Is it coming? David, please confirm this for us, because I had only heard rumors of that. Is that actually coming? So Draman said, had batch 2, worth the money. This batch 3 is supposed to be better. With NGP barrel prices so high, they get more stocks to pull from. So, all right. So Draman is already saying that it's actually worth it. So that should be cool. Bourbon Apprentice, Jason at the Match and Run, thanks so much for the sample pour of the last live stream. Tasted this straight from the barrel next to standard blends. Sat with for almost an hour sipping it. Great. Yeah, so Bourbon Apprentice won the straight from the barrel sample last week on the challenge, and he got his sample today, and he did it side to side with regular blends. So, yeah. Rare Breed Rye, please have this happen. Awesome. Okay, so no label yet, but it's coming. All right, guys. So this bottle right here will be a Rare Breed Rye. Ho, ho, ho. Oh, you just made me so excited, David. That's awesome, man. As I'm drinking some Rare Bird 101. Awesome. Oh, I forgot my, let me get my water over there. All right, guys. So we're going to dive into this mic drop now real quick. All right, so this mic drop has been opening a little bit. So let me throw up the graphic. But before we get into the graphic, I wanted to remind you guys of this coming up. If you guys haven't gotten your blends together, here is a quick reminder. That's right, guys. Just a quick reminder for Blend Again coming up. So if you guys are blending, get your entries in. If you have any blends, contact me on Instagram, on Twitter. You can email me if you don't have my email address. Let's see here. I don't know. My mom's in the kitchen right now. Robot Scott just said, what kind of super chat would it take you to get you on the live stream and say hi? How much?
$1,000.
I don't think that's happening.
Hi, everyone.
My mom literally just walked in the kitchen right now and poured some Henry McKenna. More of it. She's on her second glass right now.
I don't have my makeup on. I'm not dressed to the nines, so I cannot get on.
Oh, she said she doesn't have makeup on. You mean dress to the nines? What are you going to wear? A prom dress?
No, I like to be presentable for your viewers.
All right, I don't know. If I get any super chats, I'll let her know and maybe it'll coerce her to come on.
No, I have no makeup on, though.
Oh, she has no makeup on, so sorry, guys. so high maintenance.
Yeah.
Trev Wilson says, can't wait to send you a sample of Jephtha that I let sit outside for a week. Oh, my God. I'm truly expecting someone to send me a Jephtha or something real nasty, because I think that's really funny. The Bourbon Road said, I'm going to send in Roadmap. Oh, that would be a hard one to beat, man. That Roadmap is good. I drank mine real fast. Hey, Richie Z, what's up, man? How you doing? Hey, Jason's ma. Steven Sussman, McKenna, and Moms for the win. Yes. I totally understand the makeup thing, Mom. Karen understands. Whiskey Mix says, hello, Mrs. Mash and Drum. Robot Scott, how many entries do you have so far? So right now in hand, I have 3, but I have a bunch more on the way that people are working on or gonna be sending soon. So I definitely think we're gonna have more than 9 in this year. So it should be a really fun blend contest for everybody. All right, so let's get into what we're pouring here, the mic drop, and here are the specs on it, guys. So when they get their bottles. Now, the 2 previous releases was a lot older juice. Now, Scott from my bourbon journey, he's had both of them. I had a sample of one of them. I believe they had a 12 and a 10-year previous to this batch. And they were met with extreme popularity. I saw them being traded on the secondary market for a lot of money. People trying to trade a bottle of Mike Drop for George T. Stagg and some really popular bottles. Some success, actually. So I've seen these go on the secondary for a lot of money. But this one's only 4 years old. So this is a younger mash bill, but they did choose the high rye. Now, with younger bourbons, when you do a 4-year bourbon, when you do a 3, 4, 5-year bourbon, if you're going to release something like that, a good rye content is the way to go, because rye just works better in a younger whiskey than an older than a low rye one does. So I think they did the smart thing doing it that way. Plus, if you go to the website, they actually give you the entire story of how they picked the barrels, what they did with the whiskey, why they chose a 4-year. It's kind of cool. I mean, at least they're transparent about it. Got some questions coming in here. The return of... Can there be a worse blend contest? Maybe. let's see. Can there be the worst blend contest? I'll call out the worst one. I will. Whiskey Music drinking Ezra 7 Barrel Dovetail Old Fitz. Nice. DH Stilve, Johnny Walker Game of Thrones blend coming as soon as someone buys me the other 2. let's see here. Dark Meat Chicken, how big of a sample for the blend again? 2 ounces will be fine. As long as I get 1 tasting and then I have enough if you move further into the next round, into the finals. If you want to send more than that, that's fine. 2 ounces, 4 ounces would be plenty, but no more than that. That would be hilarious to have the worst blenders contest. Well, if somebody sends a bad blend on purpose, I'm definitely going to call it out. That would be awesome. Scott just recorded the review of this bottle yesterday for a teaser. That's a teaser, so that video is coming from Scotty. Pal Joey, Widow Jane from Red Hook. Yes, that Widow Jane. Hey, Lochness is here. Thanks for coming in, Lochness. Worst blend gets a plunger trophy. Yes. Whoever sends me the worst blend will get the rest of the bottle of my Jephthah Creed for nothing. All right, guys. So as I said, mash bill, I just see on the screen, 60% corn, 36% rye, 4% malted barley. It's got a nice high rye content. This is 56.1% ABV. Barrel proof, as all the mic drops have been, non-chill filtered for maximum flavor. And like I said, 4 years old. So let's get into the notes, see what we get here, guys. It's actually really fruity on the nose. There's a let me go back to the main scene here. It's really fruit forward. There's a little bit of there is a green aspect to it. It definitely tastes like a younger or smells like a younger bourbon. But it's very like juicy fruit on the nose right up front. There's some light caramels, light brown sugar. It's not deep, it's not rich. You know, for a 4-year, I don't think you're gonna get those deep, rich flavors. But definitely surprised at how fruity it is on the nose. This is it reminds me a little bit of like a Four Roses small batch with all like that fruit forwardness to it. So, the mic drop is this one's way cheaper, way more accessible than the other releases. This is $50 for the bottle. So, if any of you guys want to get into mic drop, then this one's an affordable kind of option, and definitely not nearly as expensive as the first two releases. All right, let's go in for a sip. Here we go. Cheers, guys. Let's see how it is. Wow, that is an orange creamsicle on the palate. Holy crap. That is so, I've never had that much of an orange punch in a bourbon before. Let me go for another sip. That was pretty wild here. Let me see. Wow. It tastes like a damn creamsicle. And it's still going. It is so orangey. It's like, yeah, it's vanilla, orange. The barrel influence starts coming in on the finish. You start getting some oak flavors. But this is all vanilla, caramel, orange. Man, if you guys have ever had like a creamsicle and just like dip it in some light caramel, that's what this tastes like. Let me go for another sip. Still, yeah, man, that orange does not go away. It is, I'm telling you guys, this is super fruity on the palate. For a four-year-old, it's not chill filtered. It's got a good palate to it. Definitely sticks. I mean, the finish is when it starts tasting a little bit young. It tastes a little bit raw. It's very, the corn in the barrel and that kind of youth kind of comes through on the back end of it. Being barrel proof, it does leave a long lingering finish, but the front and mid palate is really delicious. I mean, this is an orange bomb. It's crazy. Hey, Guy Davis is here. Thanks for coming in, Guy. I appreciate it. Cap and Make It Happen says, stop speaking my love language. Creamsicles or just food in general? Dan, that sounds nice. Hey, Moose is in the house. What's up, Moose? Jay Freezy said, Circus peanut candy. Nose. It's been a while since I've had Circus peanut candy. Don't think it's that. Duran Man said, push-up pop in a bottle. Yes, totally. The orange push-up pops. That's totally what it tastes like. Good call out. Orange creamsicle whiskey makes it move. yeah, I think if I could describe this in one way, it's definitely, if you like orange creamsicle or orange type flavor profiles, heavy citrus on a bourbon, then this would definitely be the way to go for you. Yeah, it's staying. As you keep sipping it, the orange starts taking a little bit of a backseat, but all that vanilla, the light caramels, the oak is starting now to come to the forefront. You're starting to get more of that younger oak profile to it. A little bit more of a, it's almost like that cinnamon spice that you get that goes really well with orange too. It's really nice on the finish. I like the finish a lot. It does come in hot though in the very beginning. It's very alcohol forward. It's 4 years old. It's barrel proof, non-chill filtered. So you really feel the heat in this one. Let's see what a couple drops of water does to this one. I'm curious. For science, we'll add a little bottle cap full here. Drop a little bit of water in there. Let's see what that does to it. Yeah, this is 4 years old, guys. I'll put up the stats again for those of you who just popped in because some of you just came in here. Here are the stats of the mic drop. So this is batch 3, 4 years old. You definitely get that rye spice on the end, man. The rye spice is just, it's just sitting there, lingering, tingling, hanging out, not going anywhere. Yeah, for a four-year-old bourbon, this is, I like it. It's not bad at all. It's really good. It's I happen to like that orange type, that real big citrus punch to it. So if you don't like that, then probably steer clear of this. But if you like a lot of citrus in your bourbons, then for $50 for barrel proof, this would be something to kind of seek out if you could find one. Yes, this is it's MGP, definitely MGP. And they make it well known that they source from MGP, so all right, cool. Let me go back to the main scene here. Cool. All right, so the water definitely softened up the alcohol punch in it, as you would think it would do. All right, let's go into the palate. See, now the water made it smell like, and this is going to sound funny, but like mossy, like almost like when you have an old barrel with like moss on the outside. Adding some water kind of brought that grassy note to the forefront a little bit. It's not as fruity as it was without the water. Let's go for a sip, see what the water did. Here we go. Oh. So the water killed the nose, but the palate, it's still pretty orangey. It just lightened up the flavor, and I'm not getting the nice finish I got before. So for me, I like it without water, but if you want to soften the rye punch to it, if you want to taste that finish and that tingliness of like a good rye spice, then definitely don't add water to this. Just keep it as is. Yeah, man, this is just water. You know what? The water made it a little bit lemony too. Now I think the orange kind of goes away too. Now it becomes more lemon and not so much orange. At least that's what I think I'm getting here. Pal Joey says, first issue of Mike Trap 8-year is up to 539 in the secondary market. Yeah, up for 100 retail. It is. It's crazy expensive. Yeah, so you add a little bit of water to this, and then it starts invoking more lemon rather than orange. Straight out of the glass, it's pure orange, creamsicle, vanilla, a ton of rye spice on the end. For me, I'm actually really happy I picked this up because I'm glad that MGP or what they sourced from MGP was the high rye mash bill. Like I said, it works just a little bit better. I think in this case it works way better in a younger bourbon. That rye spice really works well. The that orange flavor from the rye spice really stands out, and it's really, really delicious. So, yeah, if you guys are into orange creamsicles, then Mike Trout, definitely. All right, what do we got going on here? That's a solid weeder. What is Richie drinking? Oh, Rebel Yell 10. Love Rebel Yell 10. Pour some for mom. Yeah, you know what? I am actually going to pour some for my mom because she loves orange everything. She's the only person in the world that I know that has orange marmalade like everywhere all over the damn house. So, I think she'll really like that one because it tastes very orangey. Hey, Rick Haskew's in the house. Yo, yo, yo. Rick, I've been emailing you, buddy. Check your email through Patreon. I have that gift box for you. I just want to send it out to you. It's all boxed up. So just let me know where to send it. All right. So I'm going to let you guys choose now because I have one more that I think I could open. So I'll give you guys the choice if you want to do a quick review. I could order what?
Orange?
Yeah. So my mom heard me say orange. So, Mom, look, this mic drop has a strong orange flavor. You want to try some?
Absolutely.
All right. All right, guys. My mom wants to try some of this. Give me the glass. I told her she heard orange and now she's into it. So, Mom, look, this mic drop has a strong orange
flavor. $14.99.
Oh, Rick Haskew gets the dancing, the dancing Nick Offerman, $14.99. Thank you so much, Rick. I appreciate it. My mom actually called that out. She found it. There you go. Try that. Wait, Mom, hold on. Just you know, swirl it around a little bit. I'm going to tell you now. It's high proof.
Love it.
My mom likes high proof. Rick Haskew gets the dancing, All right, so my mom's going to give her a quick review. She doesn't want to come on cameras, but she's standing like right here. So, all right. Take a sip, Mom, because it's like pure orange. See if you taste it.
Mmm.
You taste orange?
Orange, like the rind, yeah.
Orange rind, she said. See?
Very, very smooth.
You like that one? That one's smooth to you? Well, you've been drinking McKenna for like an hour, so everything's going to be smooth to you. You're lush.
It's got a little kick to it.
Oh, yeah. It's barrel proof. You like that one?
I like it.
Do you taste the orange? Or you still taste the orange rind? All right. My mom confirms orange rind. She likes it. Go get it. She said it's smooth because she's drinking friggin' McKenna for 2 hours.
Hey, don't make fun of my McKenna. Yeah, this is not bad for a 4 year. That's 4 years old.
That's 4 years old, yeah.
Not bad at all.
You like that one?
Woo! Got a kick. That's making me very warm. Wow.
That's awesome. All right, yeah, so says it all. I heard All right, enjoy.
Thanks. Go have that. Good night, all.
All right. One thing I want to show you guys, for those of you who have never seen the mic drop, it has like this really cool, it's a glass cork, which is really different. So you pop this open. And so this is the cork. It's like a glass cork. Kind of cool. I feel like I'm going to break the thing every time I pull it out. Yeah, well, my mom says it's good. It is a buy because she's picky. But yeah, I mean, she likes it a lot. Yeah, mom's Christmas problem. I'm going to have to get her a bottle of the mic drop now. She might not let me take this one home now. She might keep this. Dram Bam, thank you, man. Good night, buddy. Thanks for coming in. Appreciate it. Awesome. Thanks for coming in. Dram Man says, choosy moms, choose my chop. Nice. Whiskey Mick, it has the Mrs. Mash Syndrome seal of approval. Exactly. But remember, she loves orange, so she heard that and came out, and she's sipping it now. So, all right, guys, so I'm going to open another bottle here. So I'll give you guys a choice what you want me to do a quick review of. So I have the Stack Junior Batch 12, the Wild Turkey Rare Breed Old School. This is the 116.8. Or I also have the Teeling single grain. Well, that one I've actually had, so I'm not gonna, I just wanna try stuff I've never had before. So Stag Junior, Wild Turkey, or Talisker Dark Storm. Which one do you want me to open up? Oh, thanks. Dram Bam saying good night to my mom. okay. Mos Chun said, oh yeah, a glass cork seals well and no cork taint. Exactly. Kind of like it. So we have Stag Rare Breed, Best 12 Stag. Your mom is seriously boss. Thanks, Emily. Oh, Talisker, Stag, Talisker, Talisker, Talisker. A lot of Talisker. Dark Storm, Stag Junior, Rare Breed. Only a couple for Rare Breed. Old School Rare Breed, Talisker. All right, I think Talisker is the winner. So let's get into the Talisker, guys. I'm excited. All right. So here we go, guys. Talisker Storm, travel exclusive. This is single malt, bottled at 45.8%. So it's got a nice proof point to it. A deep, dark, and rich maritime character, matured and selected, heavily charged cask to give extra spice and smoke. So let's open it right here, guys, live. Oh, nice. All right, let's let this one open up a little bit here, guys. This one, I mean, this is really, when you compare it to the regular Talisker, it's got a lot of good color to it. Look at that color for the Talisker. Really nice. All right, let's cork that up. If I have some time, I'll open this Stag too. Who cares? I don't think I see I don't think I see what's their names there. What was my water?
Oh,
I don't think Cast Strike is going live tonight. I didn't see a thing pop up, so I'll probably have a little bit of time. Maybe do the Stag 2 guys, hang out tonight. All right, let me mix that. All right, so this is what I'm going to do. I'm actually going to open the Stag 2 because this is a – oh, my God, that smells pretty strong. I don't want to kind of kill my palate with the peat first before I go to the Stag. So let's do the Stag. I didn't see anything with cast strength either. Master Drum, you should be good. Is that 127.9 ABV? So the Stag Junior, yes, this is 127.9. So this is batch 12. So let's get a pour. I love hanging out with you guys, man. And I love that I'm on vacation right now. So it's kind of nice. I don't have to jump off because I got to work the next day. So it's kind of cool to hang out with you guys tonight a little bit. We have 80 in the chat. Been holding steady. I really appreciate it. Trev Wilson said, I had my first Lafroy last night. Nearly killed me. Yeah, that'll happen. Oh, batch 11 is 127.9. Is it batch 11? Maybe it is batch 11. I thought I read it was batch 12. All right, batch 11. Oh. Oh, have a good night, Todd. Thanks for coming in, man. Yeah, this is pure Stag Junior, man. This is cherry cola. Caramel. This is a lot of cherry cola on this one, actually. Maybe not as much as batch 9, but close. Oh, gotcha, Steve A. Thanks, man. Yeah, one of my favorite notes on Stag Junior is the cherry cola note, and it definitely comes through on this batch a little bit. Heavy vanilla, vanilla extract almost, caramels, deep, rich brown sugars there. You know, I mean, it's really hard to argue, you know, how great Stag Junior, Stag Junior is. I really think it's great. It's a great alternative for people that can't get George T. Stag. I realize George T. Stag is much older, but, you know, there are some traits and attributes in Stag Junior that, you know, can that kind of translate to this a little bit. Oh, take care, Scotty. Gotta run, Maverick. Have a great night, buddy. We'll be talking. Everyone have a great night. Thanks, Scott. Thanks for dropping in, buddy. Appreciate it. All right, let's go for a sip of this batch and let's see what we get. Cheers. Wow. Oh, it's still going. That is awesome. I like that batch a lot. That is just pure. Well, it's a little bit of medicinal cherry. I think I got a little bit on the end. Go for another sip. Oh, yeah. That is a Stag right there. This is 127.9 proof of cherry, cinnamon, just intense vanilla, man, deep, rich caramels, maybe a, man, there's a hint of a, like a, what is that? I want to say orange, but I don't think it's orange. I think I'm just thinking of the mic drop. Mm. Yeah, and this is probably one of the more oaky and smoky Stag Juniors I've had in a while. Maybe it's just my palate the way it is right now, but I'm getting a good amount of barrel char on this one. I'm going for another sip. Yeah, the cherry is still there. That quintessential Stag Junior cherry note is still hanging out. Absolutely love it. Really, really good. Mash and Drum, I think it is better than the new batch I just got, says Trev Wilson. Interesting. So Batch 13, I believe, and for those of you who have seen it or maybe have Batch 13, I believe that's over 130 proof. Am I correct? Joseph Brazo said Batch 12 is 132.3. You know, I had it pulled up here. Let me see here. Because I was looking it up today when I was at the store. Let's go through the Stag Junior batches here. Stag Junior batches. Here we go. All right, so here's the batch information. So according to this, batch 11 was winter 2018, and that's 127.9. So this one I have is supposed to be batch 11, 127.9, released in winter 2018. Batch 12 and 13. Batch 12. $132.3. That is a, let's see here. Stag is what ECB would be if it were from Buffalo Trace. Oak and Barrel Char is speaking my language. Yeah, Whiskey Mick, there's definitely some Oak and Barrel Char here. The newest batch is 132.3. I think 12 is the newest batch. Okay. So 12 is the newest batch, and I have batch 11. So this one is one behind batch 12. But coming in over 130 proof, that's pretty strong. I would be curious to try that one. Stag Junior is reportedly about 8 years old-ish. And the Elijah Craig Barrel Proof is about 12 years old. Well, it says 12. It has a 12-year-old age statement on it. So as much as I do love Elijah Craig Barrel Proof, some of these Stag Junior batches are just delicious. Eric, wait, are you staying in New York through Labor Day weekend? Yeah, but I'm leaving the Tuesday right after to head back to Ohio, and then I'm leaving for Vegas soon after. I go to Vegas for 2 days for work. So, as this Stag Junior has opened up, guys, I just kind of left it here a little bit. The cherry note coming out of here, it's just cherry and oak right now. Where's my water? I'm going to add a little bit of water to it. See what that does. And then we're going to get into the Talisker, guys. Just a little bit. See what it does. Hey, the Oak and Smoke Whiskey Reviews is in the house. What is up, Brent? Thanks for coming in, buddy. Guys, I want to call out Eric Waite at 10:30. He's going to be premiering a new video. It's going to be a YouTube premiere. So at 10:30, I'll probably wrap up a little bit, like maybe 10:15-ish. So you guys can head over there and get ready for that premiere video. It's the 10 whiskeys to try before you die. So guys, get ready for that one. Yeah, where's my water? Thanks, Moose. I found it. So the water actually nullifies the cherry note a little bit and just brings in more classic, like, intense vanilla notes here. Let's go for a taste. It's still really good with the water, too. The water's good in there. It's still super viscous. It's still very cherry forward. It killed a little bit of the oak on the finish. So for me, I probably wouldn't like that. But if you just want more of a sweeter experience, yeah, the water does this a body good a little bit. It's really nice. Here's the color on it. So pretty dark, not too light. It's got a nice color like most Stag Juniors. But I really like this batch. I'm going to have to do a head-to-head between this one and Batch 9. Batch 9 is a lot of people's favorites. It's definitely my favorite so far. But I think that one is a contender, as they say. It's a contender. Bourbon Apprentice, I used to live in Virginia, and on occasion I ride up there and search, found Joseph Magnus and Slipknot, Iowa whiskey, shit you don't find in North Carolina. I need to try at least another 500 before I die. Eric Waite says, top 10 whiskeys to try before you die with skulls and glasses. Very nice. I actually want to thank you guys for all the positive feedback I got on my latest video that I released, my top 7 available and go-to rye whiskeys. A lot of people seem to really love the cocktail ideas that I added in there. It was just cocktails that I had had and tried with those specific rye whiskeys. So I'm glad you guys got a lot out of it. I really appreciate the cool feedback on it. It's a cool video. It's doing really well. I put about a week's worth of time into that one with cocktails and the research for each bottle. So I appreciate it, guys. Drambam, thank you, man. Said Talisker 18 is so good. Yes, I love Talisker 18, and I'm trying to find one. I love that stuff. This one is a really good placeholder in the meantime while I'm trying to find it. Drambam says, everyone loves a top list. Yeah, I mean, it's true. I haven't put one out in a while, so it's kind of, I'm like, I don't want to just, you know, throw a top list together. I figured I'd do a rye one because I feel like ryes don't get a lot of love sometimes. So, and I've had some really good ryes lately, especially the Wild Turkey Cornerstone kind of triggered it in my mind. I'm like, man, what would my other like favorite ryes be? So that's why I kind of wanted to work on that video. Chad Wallace said the Boulevard Deer is bomb. ADHD Fishing says everyone loves topless. Well, it depends on who's topless, man. Oh, that's good. All right, I'm a big fan of that Stag Junior batch. Batch 11, awesome. All right, let me have some more water, and we'll get ready to have some Talisker, guys. Bourbon Rose said, anyone going to the Kentucky State Barbecue Festival at Wilderness Trail? I would love to. Joseph Brazo, lots of rye flights. Pal Joey said, let's see mom. Oh, dude. I won't tell her who said that. Eric, wait, the time and energy you put into the top 7 rye video makes all the other whiskey tubers look bad. I appreciate that, Eric. Yeah, I did put a lot of time into that one. I was proud of that video, so. Bourbon Apprentice, yeah, the cocktail list was the shit. Need to buy some of the mixers and liquors to make them. I will say this, guys. If the Boulevard Deer, the Vucare and the last one, which was the Black Walnut Old Fashioned, those would be my three I would tell you guys to try. The Black Walnut Old Fashioned is an absolutely great cocktail for the fall, which is coming soon. So not really sure how easy it is to find Black Walnut bitters. I got mine on Amazon. So if you can, you know, definitely order them and try it. I'm telling you, it's such a great cocktail. The Pikesville that I had that particular rye in just worked brilliantly with that sweet flavors in it. But I'm sure you could experiment with different ryes and maybe find one that's that you like really well. Peter White says Talisker 8 cask strength is being released at the LCBO as they're usually 1 year behind. Oh, okay. I haven't seen that one either. DJ Beacon, you should see the Talisker 18 in Vegas for about $150. If I see it in Vegas, I'm grabbing it because I haven't seen it yet. Jason, we have a little Tally 18 here in Houston. I can email you one. Drambam, thank you, man. Definitely get in touch with me. I would be interested in that. Joseph Brazos has really been digging on the Sazerac cocktail lately. Awesome. Joseph, what kind of absinthe are you using in your Sazerac? Just curious. Bourbon Road, a gem. Will there be recording for the event? Let me see here. Will there be recording? Oh, we will be there recording for the event. Oh, cool. Awesome, man. I know I've mentioned before, but those of you who haven't checked out the Bourbon Road, the podcast, definitely go check out the Bourbon Road. They're putting out some really awesome content. It's bourbon focused, but it's more also about the experience and the heritage and the agrarian kind of lifestyle, just living in Kentucky, as well as the great bourbon lifestyle, kind of all intertwined and mixed in. It's a really great podcast. I always listen to it. They just had Fire Birdo, who's a guitarist. I follow him on Instagram. He's also a tour guide at Wild Turkey, and he's an awesome guy. And Bourbon Road just did a podcast interviewing him. So go check that one out, guys. Mash and Drum, there should be topless in Vegas. Yeah, definitely. Okay. All right, so let's get into the Talisker Dark Storm now. I'm really excited to get into this one. Never had it. I wish I had a little Talisker to compare to it, but my mom doesn't drink Talisker, and I don't have any here, apparently, so. All right, so let's go into the nose here. I mean, this does smell a lot darker and richer than most Taliskers I've had. Man, this is a ton of citrus on this, but like, you ever go to a bar and they, like if you order an old fashioned or a smoked old fashioned and they actually like light the rind on fire, that's what it smells like. It's like a smoky, smoky type of like orange rind. Really interesting. Eric, wait, since you don't have a drum cymbal, Bosch should bang on pots and pans for super chats. Thank you, Eric, wait. You get the dancing Nick Offerman. Thank you so much, man. Cheers. Bang on pots and pans. I wish my grandmother's downstairs and she would come up and bang on a pot and pan for you. My grandma just celebrated her 95th birthday, guys. So she's amazing. Love her to death. She's actually downstairs right now, probably passed out. I might be keeping her up. Dark Meat, so when are you going to host the Mash and Drum meetup with the Jeff the Creed Distillery? that would be awkward. Yeah, I don't know. Hopefully their stuff gets better. I really hope their stuff gets better because, you know, they are great people that run that distillery. You know, okay. So let me look up here some attributes here of the Talisker Dark Storm. Let's see here. Okay, so Talisker Dark Storm. This is, let's see, only released travel retail market heavily. I don't see any notes on it as far as age. Let's see if there's some age on this one. So this is originally released exclusively to. The main difference between these two expressions, between this one and the Storm, is that Dark Storm is matured in heavily charred oak cask, adding a level of smokiness. Okay. Anybody know the age of this? This is it's an NAS, but I don't know if anyone has any idea of how old this could be. Oh, thanks for the birthday wishes. I'll tell Grandma when she wakes up next morning. Oh my goodness. This smells like bacon. It really does. This is like bacon in a glass. That smoke character does come through. I'm saying bacon, but it's really this kind of deep, rich, oaky characteristic to it. Man, a lot of citrus. A little bit of a cherry note in there too, I think. But definitely, it's very meaty. It's very, very smoky, smoke forward. Those super charred oak casks are really good. ADHD Fishing said, Grandma has got to be hounding you about when you're going to find a nice girl. She does, every time I see her. I'm working on it. It's tough out there. I'm 42, I'm 42 years old, so trying to date at 42 becomes a little bit more problematic because, you know, it's just how it is, guys. So. Let's see. Yeah, this is like if you took cherry bitters and threw them on top of bacon and then took a bite. That's what this smells like on the nose. Oh my goodness, man. This has an incredible nose. I could smell this all day. Let's go in for the palate. I cannot wait to try this stuff. Here we go. Cheers. Oh, that tastes like bacon too. A little bit. Oh, we got Arthur Lopez. We have the dancing Ron Swanson, guys. When you said absinthe earlier, I immediately thought of the song Spirit from Ghost. Sending some Talisker 10 since that's all I could find locally. Arthur Lopez, thank you so much, man. Appreciate that. Thank you for the super chat. Here is to you. sipping along with some Talisker with me. So I'm going to go for a second sip and kind of give you guys some more experience here. Here we go. It's very smoky and very peppery. There's almost a there's a lot of pepper aspect to this, especially on the finish. Who was it? I think it was Cap'n Make It Happen said like chili pepper. And I could totally see that. Chili pepper, bacon, smoke. There's definitely still a sea salt aspect to this. It's not super mouth coating. This comes in at 45.8. But that extra spice and smoke really kind of makes up for the proof point on this one. Man, I like that a lot. Man, I am so happy I found this. Methinks this is not going to last long. That's really nice. Richie Z says, damn, you look younger than your age, Jason. Oh, thanks, Richie. Appreciate that, man. Moose76, what goes good with bacon? Anything? So I always do this thing when people like you ever go to a restaurant and people ask you, oh, do you have any dietary requirements? Just as a joke, I always say, yes, I must have bacon. Oh, we got another dancing Ron Swanson. Joseph Brazo donated $5 with Super Chat. Okay, fine. Take 70% of my money. Thank you, Joseph Brazo. Very, very appreciated. Thank you so much, man. I appreciate the Super Chat. Thank you, man. Cheers. Cap'n Make It Happen. Yep, red chilies and citrus and the cherry makes sense. Come to think of it. Yeah, man. I'm getting a ton of cherry and citrus on here. Cherry, citrus, meaty bacon, and chili pepper all day in this glass. Delicious. Love this stuff. Oh, this is going to be hard not to drink all this on vacation while I'm sitting here. This is awesome. Peter White, Talisker. Okay. Let's see. All right, you guys are... Oh, Dremon says, my great-grandma, keys to a long, healthy life. Simple, eat less, drink more. Happy birthday, Grandma. Thank you so much, Dremon. I appreciate that. Actually, Grandma had a little bit of wine tonight. She wanted a little bit of her White Zinfandel, so she had some before she went to bed. She likes a good drink every now and then. Moose76, smoked bacon, peppered bacon, candied bacon, thick bacon, thin bacon. Yeah, you said it all, Moose. Absolutely. let's see. Okay, let's go for another sip of this one. Ah. Yeah, the chili pepper aspect to it, like a sweet chili pepper is now becoming more prominent now on the palate. The more sips you take, the bacon flavor is still there, but the more you sip, the more this smoky pepper kind of takes over. You still get a little bit of that cherry too. It's really nice. I love that one. All right. Good to go, man. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour one last pour tonight and before we sign off here. And this is... That's the Wild Turkey. That's the mic drop. So I'm going to stick with some Wild Turkey. I'm going to do a little bit of a blend of my own to get you guys ready for Blendageddon. So I'm going to take Wild Turkey 101. I'm going to take my 1792 Bottled and Bond pick. Pour a little of that in there. And I'm going to take some Stag Junior, the new batch, and pour that in there too. Make a little quick blend. Oh, Dancing Ron Swanson. Who do we got? WhiskeyBrazil.com donated $5. Great channel. He said Skull Vikings. Thank you so much, Whiskey Brazil. I appreciate it. Whiskey Brazil has just kind of become a really, really cool guy that I've been talking to lately. He's been commenting on my videos. He has a huge channel. Go check out Whiskey Brazil. Really cool guy. Thank you so much, Whiskey Brazil. I really appreciate you coming in and watching tonight. Cheers. Going to let this mingle a little bit. Richie Z, Canadian bacon is great. Yes, it is. Canadian bacon is delicious. The best bacon I've ever had, guys, was a... it was in... where the hell was I? I got to think where I was now, where I had it. I believe it was Montreal. I think it was in Montreal. And they had... so, I mean, this bacon was like this. It was super, super... So, wait, dancing Nick Offerman. Robot Scott donated $10 to the Super Chat. He said, if Scott had 10 pieces of bacon and Katie wants 3 of them, how many pieces of bacon does Scott have? I was sending me riddles now after drinking. And Katie wants 3 of them. How many pieces of bacon does Scott have? I would imagine he would still have all 10 because I wouldn't give Katie any of my bacon. Or Scott could have no bacon. If Katie wants 3, she might get it all. I would say no. It's my bacon. Oak and Smoke Whiskey Reviews. Jason, you rock, buddy, at the Master General. Oh, thanks, man. Oak and Smoke Whiskey Reviews, another great channel, another new channel on YouTube. Go check out Brent. Great group of guys over there. Double Smoked Wild Boar Bacon. Ridiculously good. That sounds amazing, Vaughn. Damn, that sounds really good. So this piece of bacon I had in Montreal was, really, really thick cut, came out, it was about this long. It was a ridiculously long piece of bacon, about this thick, and it was dusted in, brown sugar, red chili powder, and then it also had like this like custom, like this homemade glaze that they made, like this sweet glaze that they put on top of it, and then the sugar and the chili pepper was on top of it. You could pick up this stuff, and it was completely like, hey, got a new subscriber. John Piper just subscribed. Thank you, John. Thanks for subscribing to the channel. It literally was like I could pick this thing up. It was like a board. It was like so thick and crispy. It was the most amazing piece of bacon I ever had. I wanted to keep eating it and eating it and eating it. It was insane. Cap and make it happen, and that response might explain you being single. You guys ever see that episode of Friends when Joey's like, Joey doesn't share food? That's me. It's my bacon. All right, so I'm going to taste my my blend here. So this is Stag Jr. blended with 1792, my store pick, Bardstown Magic, and the... Wild Turkey 101. So, last pour of the night, guys. Let's go in. Cheers. Thanks for hanging out with me tonight in New York. Here we go. Cheers. Oh, that's a good blend. That would be a contender right there. ADHD Fishing says, Jason wakes up in the morning after an evening with a new lady, proceeds to eat every piece of bacon, and then wants to know why it didn't work out. If only that was untrue, buddy. Oh, my God. Oh, Brendan Weiss, you got the cutting board. The Master Jerome, you never said your cutting board was glass. Yeah, isn't it really cool? I'm glad you got it, Brendan. Cheers, man. Good job for winning that. Now, let me ask, do you guys out there want to win samples? Because I might do a quick question here, but I can't send them out until I get home. So I'm willing to send you guys a sample of the mic drop if you want, if you guys want to try it. Before we sign off real quick. Oh, we got another dancing Ron Swanson. Arthur Lopez, again, donated $1.99. He said, have you had the Balcones High Plains single malt? I've never had the High Plains, but I'm a huge fan of Balcones. They do amazing stuff. You guys have heard me kind of, carry on about how much I love their French oak. Their rye is super unique, super delicious. Love it. Do it, do it. Yep, samples are always good. Yes, Samper. Answer. Bacon. Yes, Moose. All right. So I'll see how close you guys were paying attention to the chat. Or I'm sorry, to the news segment. But again, when I get back home to Ohio, I will send out, I'll do two samples of the mic drop tonight, guys, that I'll send out to you guys to try that creamsicle deliciousness. So, okay. So first one to say in the chat, based on my chat, now remember, I might see a different chat than you. So it's based on what I see. What was the body of water that Castle and Key had the rum overnight? Then brush on some maple syrup, sprinkle brown sugar, and cook in the oven until done. Holy crap, Karen. I am trying that. That sounds ridiculous. Trev Wilson, Creek. You're halfway there. Come on, that creek had a specific name. Bourbon Apprentice at Lake Champlain. East River, no. The Bourbon Road, Glen's Creek. Jim Shannon. You get a sample of Mic Drop 3.0. Congrats, Jim. All right, another sip of the blend. All right, what else we got here? Trev Wilson said, I knew it was a creek. Rick Haskew says, do it now. Do it, do what? Do it now. Am I supposed to do Arnold Schwarzenegger? All right. All right, so this should be a quick one. So before, during the news, I had mentioned, well, congrats to Jim Shannon real quick. He got the first sample tonight. He's going to get a Mic Drop 3.0. Great job, man. All right. The first one to name the name of Highland Park's newest release, the Highland Park Blah, gets the next sample and go. Do it now, do it. Oh, Steve A. I just saw Steve A got it. The Vol Father. Steve A, man, you got it. Robot Scott said Black and Steelers. Awesome, man. All right. I saw Steve A got it. So Steve A and Jim Shannon, you guys will win a sample of the Mic Drop 3.0. Thank you so much for coming in. Really appreciate it, guys. This was a really fun night hanging out in New York with you guys on a Whiskey Wednesday. Thank you all to whoever sent in a super chat. I really, really appreciate it. Get your blends together. If you guys haven't yet, reach out to me. If you have a blend you're working on and want to send them in, reach out to me. I'll tell you where to send them. Yes, Stevie, I do have your address. Thank you again so much. And I'm going to have some of my blend here. Actually, I'm going to finish off with the Talisker because this stuff is really, really good. So, cheers, everyone. Thanks for coming in. Thanks for hanging out on a Whiskey Wednesday night. Head over to Eric Waite's channel on 10:30 for his top 10 whiskeys to try before you die. As I always say, it is not about the whiskey. It is the people you share it with. Cheers to everyone. Thank you for hanging out with me tonight, and I will see you next time. Take care, everybody. Cheers.